Welcome in the name of Jesus. Thank you for joining. Thank you for coming. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Welcome once again, newcomers, first timers, welcome. I want to talk to you the subject called The Power of Bewitchment, Spells, and Enchantment. There is power called bewitchment and spells and enchanters. When somebody is being witched, he obeys some strange commands. He operates under another commands. He or she, this person, they always obey strange commands. They obey strange commands. Then when a person is bewitched or spells on the person, spells is controlling you, that you are so being manipulated. You are manipulated. And now what you are, you have people who manipulate you, and you have people who you are manipulating. So you might find yourself manipulating people, and people manipulate you. Enchantment is a group of witchcraft where they are operating. There is no godness there. There is pride. There is a spirit of highly pride and arrogance. Such a people, they can never apologize. Such a people, they think they know better than anybody. They think they have all information, but they have none. They are operating under bewitchment. They are bewitched. They are witched. They witch themselves. They go for power. They are being witched. Anytime they are open themselves, they don't want to run. You can't tell them anything. They don't want to run. They are unteachable. They are very complicated people. They are people who are disgracing. They have no shame. They don't have shame. They can disgrace you. They can really embarrass you. They can disgrace you in front of people. And also they have no manners. They have no manners. No manners, another name. They are no manners. People, when people are just wondering, looking at them, what's wrong with these people? What's wrong? You only wonder, what is this? You wonder, but the person is operating under witchcraft. There is some evil spirit operating with the evil spirit, with the spirits. Both of them, they are evil, but one is stronger than another. When an evil person being directed by evil spirit, the person is evil and is being directed by the evil spirit. Now, when they operate together, it makes the person, because he thinks that these people, because they obey the strange command, they obey the commands from the demons, from the witchcraft, from the powers of darkness. When they obey this command, it comes in their head. They hear it very clear. And then this command them what to say and what to do. Now, anytime they start talking, this command will come in their mind, and they will start making mistakes. Then you see people are looking down, or people are dancing on the chair, people are holding themselves. I know we had a pastor, apostle, and this pastor, there was a big congregation. But the pastor, the moment he would start talking, he would disgrace people. He would talk so bad. He talk bad words. He doesn't know there's elder people, there's young people. He was really disaster. It was so bad. Now, even you can't take the guest. You can't tell people that this is your apostle, this is your pastor. Because the pastor was so arrogant, so evil. I've never seen such a pastor like that. And then when I visited that church, I went there almost 1 month because I wanted to believe, what do I see? What is this? And then I was shocked. The pastor was making a lot of mistakes. And even his preaching itself, it is like he's preaching from, not from the Bible. He's preaching his own Bible. his own. He reads the Bible very well. You see, he's reading the scripture, but the way he talks is something else. Now, this is bewitchment. This is witchcraft. And these people, it is very difficult for them to correct them. You cannot correct them. They have names. They have nicknames. They call you Mr. So and So. You can't correct them. You can't help them. You can't help. They have some individuals who they trust, and these individuals also they are operated by evil, by witchcraft. Now, evil person being directed by evil. You see how it works. The enemy which operating in their life, they program evil upon evil. No good person will come and help them. They fight the good people, they fight the true people, they want themselves, they want themselves, because they are under bewitched. They are bewitchment, they are being witched. Now, when they are witched, this is very true. The scripture says in the book of Revelation 16 verse 14. The Bible says in the book of Revelation 16 verse 14, they said, these are demons, demonic spirits that perform signs and go out to all the kings of the earth to assemble them for battle on the great day of God, the Almighty. They are the spirit that performs signs and miracles. They can choose their leader. These demons, this witchcraft, they can choose their leader. And when the leader comes, you think the leader has come to lead you, everybody. But they have come. They have come to make sure that they destroy people, they ruin people, they neglect people, they affect people so much. By the time this person will be removed or will go, people would be holding their stomach and breathe. There are people like Jezebel, there are people like Ahab, whom God has to kill him because he was so wicked and evil. He was operated by witchcraft, and himself he was bewitched, and he was operating in witchcraft. He is bewitched, and he is a witch, and is operating under witchcraft. Such a people, They are very, 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 very dangerous. You wonder, they make mistakes. They don't fear, they don't care anybody. Their work is to destroy, to make mistakes, to disgrace people. And people are watching. King Ahab, he was the king of Israel. And he messed up. He did wicked and evil. He did wicked, wickedly. But he was a king. But God himself had to use the spirit to kill him. God has said himself, when the prophet Micaiah went to prophesy to him and tell him what to do, he slapped Micaiah and put him in prison because he has power. You can't talk anything. You can't correct him. You can't say he will fire you, he will destroy you. When a prophet Micaiah went to talk to Ahab, what Ahab said, he slapped him and beat him and threw him to prison. That is when a person is being witched. And is working under witchcraft. The person is bewitched and is operating with the witchcraft and is working under witchcraft. That is how it operates. And the person, it is very difficult for this person to be corrected because he has refused. He knows everything. He obeyed strange commands. Now, this person, hallelujah, these satanic agents also use curses, spells, incarnation, and death to torment its victim. You know, it torments people so much. It torments people. People who are under them, they fear. They walk in fear. They are terrifying because they don't know they will be the next person. You will be fired. You will be thrown to prison. You will lose the job. You work under the commandment. You work under the leadership where you can't say anything. The moment you say anything, gone. The moment you open your mouth, dead. They torment people so much. And now we have people like King Saul. King Saul became very rebellious. And then God has to reject him. And it's God who chooses him. is God who used King Saul. But King Saul was become so wicked and evil. What happened? God has to kill him. So this wicked, when a person is being witched and working with under bewitchment and is operating under witchcraft, that is the result. You can be witched. You can be bewitched. But through the grace of God, God can deliver you if you are willing. But because you are also, you have entered into the witchcraft, then you got a very strong one who are above you. And then they give you a command to operate by commanding you what to do. You have no place for God. You have no place for the godly people to correct you, to pray with you, or to stand with you. You reject everything. And then you become a victim, a highly victim of the enemy and the meat of the devil. Hallelujah. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Bewitchment is when someone uses evil power like witchcraft to charm, to enslave, or to mislead people. This evil power can be used on a person, a place, or a thing. Wicked people issue curses on good and innocent people, and who has not done anything wrong to them. And then this bewitchment, it is used. Bewitchment is when someone is used evil power like witchcraft to charm the person. They charm the person. When a person, you will see, people will see, this is witchcraft. This is witchcraft. Because people are making a lot of mistakes. They are not supposed to make mistakes. But they make these commands. When they obey the commands is the one which tells them what to say. They don't hear. You can talk to them. You think they are hearing, but then none. They don't hear anything. It is them to hear. That's how you know the person is being witched. The person is operating under bewitchment. And these people, as long as you know you are not normal, call for prayer, call for deliverance, because that is how you will find yourself. Why am I making mistakes like this? Why this anything I'm doing is I'm not doing good? I don't know if you have never seen this. You try to do everything good, but you find you are doing mistakes. You are doing mistakes. Check yourself. If you are working under bewitchment, if you are being witched, or you are being a witch, you can be a witch yourself, and you have no idea. So you have to call upon the name of Jesus. You see, Jezebel was a woman operating with witchcraft. And she was very wicked and evil. And she had that spirit of pride. When a person is being witched, a bewitchment person, a person who is witched, things you see from that person is pride, arrogant. The person who does not respect anybody, it doesn't have any respect, they don't respect anybody. They are very arrogant. They talk like the way they want because they see nothing you can do to them. They don't fear any, even they don't fear God. They don't fear God. They don't fear anybody. They don't fear nobody. They want you to fear them. They want you to obey them. That is how they operate. A false prophet called me, and this man, I knew he's a bad person. He's not a nice person. He was talking to me and commanding me to reason. And he doesn't want me to talk anything. He wanted to put something in my spirit. Now I know that I'm in danger. So I resist by using the fire of God. And then I started saying, you know, everything you are talking to me, let the fire of God consume them. Let the fire of God consume. And then he became very angry with me and said, you know, when I talk, you don't have to talk. You have to keep quiet and listen. And this is what God has said. I said, that's why I'm using the fire of God. If it is God talking, fire is fire. So fire cannot destroy fire. God is a fire, is a consuming fire. He will receive it. But if it's from the kingdom of darkness, it will not manifest. It will not operate in my life. So that's how we end up and we deeper, and then he went hungry, he banged the phone and left angry. Because I knew that it's going to put a wrong spirit in my head and it will torment me, and that is witchcraft. He was trying to put a witch spells on me, but it didn't work for him. At the end, when he banged his phone down, he said, I don't know what I'm going to do with you. I said, you can't, because the fire of God will consume everything. That's how you will escape. Run to no, run mistakes. Correct yourself. Repent. Apologize. And check and see if you are under bewitched, or you are controlling under witchcraft, or you yourself, you are a witch. Some people, they can be blind witch. They can be really witch who went to buy witchcraft, and they don't know what to do. Now they are, have entered in a really serious, serious battle. But the God of heaven will deliver you in Jesus' name. If you are teachable, be teachable. Change. Don't say you know everything. Don't say you know everything. You need help. You need to be the advice. You need to be, you need to be, you need to help. You know, when you think you know everything, you don't know everything. When you always fight, you argue, you calm down and the Lord of heaven will help you. If you will know, because you will feel that I am operating something which is not normal. You must see. You will know that you are operating under influence of witchcraft. I know I come from Africa, and I know how this works, how these things work. I have seen people spiritually and physically who are being witched. You might see there was a principal, a lecturer. He was a counselor, a lecturer in the university. The person, when he was bewitched, this person, what he did, they had an helper, the person, a young girl who came to help them. Now, he has a beautiful wife, and the wife also is a lecturer. Both of them, they are lecturers in a university. Now, it happened that the man decided to go and have affairs with this little girl. This the helper, a maid, a servant who is helping them, who is working for them. The girl didn't go to school. She's working there, paid. They are paying her little money. She has little. She's just the child, the girl who is helping them. And then this man loved the girl and went to have an affair with her. And the same demon that took the lecture to this girl, the same demon went and told the man, the woman, the wife, come and see what your husband is doing. And now, that was a huge bewitchment. That was a huge witchcraft. After that, what happened? The woman started screaming because, of course, a woman cannot find a husband on doing this. It's a shocking. It's a strange. The woman did do anything. That is what every woman can do. The woman started screaming. He started beating the girl. And then when he screamed, people come. You know, if you scream, people will say, do you need help? What is this? And Africa, when you give a little scream like that, a lot of people will come to your door to help and see what it is. They found a lecturer naked and this girl crying. And the girl is innocent. She's innocent. She didn't go to the man. The man went to him, to her. You see, that is witchcraft. Now, through that, the man lose a job. The woman loses the support. The children become fatherless. They become fatherless. They scattered. Everything scattered. And that was the end of everything because there was bewitchment. And now they didn't take time. They didn't get time because it was programmed very well. Bewitched person, you will see mistakes they make. But you can help yourself. Before it has reached that way, you can go for deliverance and prayer. Because the Bible says in the book of Ecclesiastes 11 verse 12, the Bible says this witchcraft, they don't have power. They don't have power. You don't have to fear them. They have no power. They are there. But if you want, God will help you and deliver you. You will be delivered from that, from witchcraft. The Bible says in the book of Ecclesiastes 9, verse 11 to 12, the Bible says, I have seen something further under the sun, that the swift do not always win the race, nor do the mighty win the battle. You know, this witchcraft, they don't win always. It depends how you give them power, how you believe them. They can't. Look at this. The swift do not. This is witchcraft. Witchcraft does not always win. It would win to some people, but not all of them. And once they win, and the blood of Jesus, Jesus will come and destroy them. They cannot win because God is a winner. They will come and torment you. But when you know the truth, when you know Jesus Christ, when you know the Messiah, the Lord Jesus Christ, Jesus will destroy them. Witchcraft, they are there and they are lily and they are working, but they have no power. God has taken all their powers. Jesus has taken the powers. They use the powers of the devil, the enemy, Satan, Lucifer. Now, Lucifer, Satan, the devil has been defeated by the blood of Jesus. He tried even to kill Jesus, but Jesus defeated him by his resurrection. And he was resurrected, and he told the disciples, I am gone, but I'm giving you power and authority. Once you have this power and authority, the witchcraft cannot do anything. That's why we are want to pray for you, pray for the people who are being witched, who are being operated by spells, chants, incarnation, all sources of witchcraft, black magic, red magic, all the wicked powers of witchcraft they are using. The Bible has given us power against them. Look at that scripture. The Bible says, I have seen something farther under the sun, that the swift do not always win the race, nor do they might win the battle, nor do the wise always have the food, nor do the intelligence always have the riches, nor do this with those with knowledge always have success, because time and unexpected events overtake them all. For man does not know his time. Just as fish are caught in an evil net and birds are caught in a time of disaster, when it suddenly overtaken them. You see, this is what Solomon, the man God gave a lot of wisdom. When he was watching and see, he said that you can see people who are called them wealthy, riches, very smart, whatever, but not always. Not always. The time will come when their riches and the wealth cannot help them. And it can fly. You can see this is what the Bible says. They cannot win. They will win for a short time, but the time will come when they will be useless and be rendered powerless. They can be defeated. They can be caught, and their life will be ruined and be destroyed in Jesus' name. So we pray that God will help you in Jesus' name. By the power and the blood of Jesus, I decree and declare by the power that created the heaven and earth, in the mighty name of Jesus, everyone that is being under witchcraft, under spells and chants and witchcraft, let it be destroyed in Jesus' name. Let the fire of God consume them. Let them be rendered powerless in Jesus' name. I pray that God will arise and destroy every enemy using witchcraft, using powers of darkness, using evil against your life, against your family in Jesus' name. Let them be destroyed. Let them be rendered powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I destroy you wicked personality using witchcraft, charms, and black magic against the people in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I pray the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I give you all the glory, my Father, my God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, as I come before you, before your presence, Lord, I commit your people into your hand. I pray that God Almighty destroy every evil hand, destroy every hand of witchcraft, destroy every hand of evil people, wicked and personality who are rising against you, who are rising against your children, are rising against your family, bringing confusion. In the mighty name of Jesus, I destroy them. I bind them. When a person is being witched, you find this person is so confused. First of all, they get confused. His mind is not stable. He gets confused. He can't operate properly. You plan very well, but when you reach the time to do it, you find you are totally confused. You don't understand. You don't know what you are doing. And then people will look at you and say, with this person, we give a job. We give this person work to do. How is it? It's like it's doing. Like it does. Does this person knows what he's doing? Does this really person know what he's doing? And then you make people who are working with you angry. They get angry of you. They get angry and they get upset. They said, why you are not doing the right thing? We told you to do this and you are doing opposite. You said you are trained. You come from college. You did interview. You passed the interview. We thought you know what you are doing. Now you start, then fear start come to you. You get fear. You hate the job. You start hating the job. You start hate everybody. You feel like people are against you. You find yourself now. You start arguing. You start become bitter, and you start saying people are against me, and you feel rejection because of this bewitchment that has sent a conviction demon in your mind to make you do mistakes, to make you not do the right thing. Instead of opening the door for the enemy, thinking you are being rejected, you feel bad about yourself, you fear even to do the job. The next day when you are going, you fear and then you continue making mistakes. After that, they will tell you we don't need you here. You will be fired or you resign because you get embarrassed. You can't do things properly. You know you can do it. But the moment you start working, the moment you start doing that, you will make a great mistake. There was a person, a man was hired to drive a minister in Africa. In Africa, the ministers, they are driving with the Mercedes-Benz, good cars. Now this man was a grade one driver, very good driver. He has he was very good driver. Now he did his interview, he passed the interview, and then the minister was confident that he's a good driver. And then one day, well, they were doing presidential escort. They were going to the meeting, and you know, they drive very fast because they are themselves. Now what happened? This driver, what he did? He was on speed, and I don't know what making mistakes. He break. He said he saw a cow in front of him, and there was no cow. He saw a cow, and he tried to break. He tried to break so that the car can stop. The moment he touched the brake, you know, when you are in speed, if you break, what will happen? You will roll, yeah. You roll and you will kill yourself, you will kill everybody. And because the other cars were following him, everybody, the accident was big. And the car rolled, of course, and that was very serious. And everybody said, the driver so-and-so, he's known as a good driver. What happened? But because of God, because of the grace of God, the car got accident and nobody died, but the cars were damaged. And by the time, the president has already gone, and the people who were following him were delayed a little bit, and they had to change another car, and they were wondering. That was bewitchment. He did a huge mistake. And he did a huge mistake. That's how it is. And you know you are an expert. You are an expert. But because of bewitched, you find you are doing mistake. In the name of Jesus, any witchcraft making you to do mistake, let them be destroyed. Let them be wasted. Let them be rendered powerless in Jesus' name. I pray that God will deliver you from the hands of bewitchment, from the hands of witchcraft, spells and chants, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I pray the blood of Jesus over these people, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, deliver them. Lord, deliver your people in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power of witchcraft, every enemy using witchcraft, using powers of darkness to attack you, to torment you, to destroy your work, to affect you, let them die in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I want to thank you. Lord, I bless your name. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I bless you. I thank you, Jesus. I give you the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, amen. I want to thank everybody. I have to stop here. God will help you in Jesus' name. See you tomorrow morning, 9 p.m. God, 9 a.m., not 9 p.m. We will have prayer meeting 9 p.m. tonight and 9 p.m. tomorrow night and 9 a.m. We have 9 a.m. and 9 p.m. tomorrow and today. Today we are having our AM, 9 a.m. Tonight we have popcorn prayer and prayer conference. Thank you, Father, much. God bless you. There is a lot of destruction that has come. Somebody decided to bring destruction. You know the enemy is a liar. So I have to stop here. Talk to you tomorrow and in the morning, 9 a.m. And tonight we are on. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Sigi, saying bye-bye. Bye-bye, bye-bye, bye-bye.